right, welcome to game two here of this spring 2023 CSUN Basketball Invitational. This time, the two teams that were defeated in the first round, CSUN UC Riverside facing off. UC Riverside lost to Cal Poly 70-59. And UC Riverside will draw first blood. It is 2-0. Because of the shortage of time between both games, I could not get full names from UC Riverside, only their first name and last initial. That's how I'll be referring to them. UC Riverside number 1 is Cy. Number 10, Lloyd. Number 11, James. Number 23, Brian. Number 0, Nate. Number 7, Daniel. Some of them are wearing different uniforms. Might get confusing for those watching. The gentleman in the blue jersey is playing on UCR. One of these teams will go on 0-2 today. That CSUN does not want it to be them. Number 12 for CSUN, I got his name, is Jordan Coleman. So there'll be no more changes or additions today. Matadors take their first lead in any game today, 4-2. James is taking his time. Nearly a turnover. They're still able to get possession, but way into Matador's court. I can sort of tell see their last names from here. So Nate is Nate Narisco and number 7, Daniel George Lee. Jaden Randolph will take his first trip to the free throw line for this matchup against UC Riverside. Brian will sink a 3. One thing that Occidental did not do well last match was covering Mikhail English. I heard that while I was down there before the game started, their plans to tightly cover him and not let him shoot from the three-point line, because he's been on fire today from there. Outside the three-point line. So where Mikhail English plays his best. Cal Poly is leading Occidental 20-16. Five 5 minutes in and no team has reached double digits yet. See if that game plan will work for them. Trying to contain Mikhail English, and it does not. He puts up two. Does not. He does not because drew a foul, and he'll take a trip to the free throw line instead. It's up one, and there, CSUN has double digits. 10-6. George Lee puts it up. Bounce off the rim. They're trying to get it again. And foul. And number one is Cy Burla. Looks like the line right behind the net. A little squeaky and need someone to clean that up. Burla, free throw, rolls around the rim, just bouncing around. Cy Burla is 2 for 2 on free throws. Matters take over now. Jason Maturi will bring it out, pass it to Mikhail English. Sean Nelson will go for three. His foot was on the line, so it would have been two, but didn't matter, did not go in, and moves up in the paint. Could not go it, not get it in, and Maturi unable to get the rebound. Instead, Nate Naresco with the alley-oop puts up two. Nearly losing possession and letting it roll out of bounds there was Maturi, but he's able to recover it and put up two more. And the scoreboard operators are making a couple of mistakes. They're down. See, a 17-10. Cy Burla moving up, not able to get up. It's in the paint, and he falls down. He's not even in the field of play, looking for a foul. Not going to get one. Sean Nelson puts up three. He sinks it. Nothing but net. And that was a three-pointer, but they only give him two. And by the way, sir, Cy Burla is looking for one again. Good sportsmanship by Mikhail English. And it should be 22-12. That was a three-pointer by Sean Nelson, and whoever's operating the scoreboard is not paying attention to the feet. So the score is 22-12, but the court scoreboard says 21-12. They did not see that Sean Nelson had both feet on Brown. Not on the three-point line. So that delayed that to them. At halftime, someone will let them know. But, yeah, the score is 22-12. Orisco moving around several CSUN defenders, able to get the alley-oop for two. Kyle Wilson, tried to pass it to Mahita Ogogo. Pass was too quick and didn't see it in time, and it went out of bounds, and UC Riverside's ball. Brian sinks it up, sets it up, and sinks 3 points. Kyle English puts up two, no, it goes in, it gets his own rebound, bounces out again, and UC Riverside will take over. Oh, and no look, he was trying to pass it behind him. There was no one there. He passed it right to Mikhail English, but that didn't go up either, and that might draw a foul. Very interesting turn of events right there. Riverside taking their time. Whistle's blown and foul called on UC Riverside, and Matadors gonna take over now. Mahita Ogogo will take it out. Jason Maturi going for three and bounce out the rim. Jamie Chacon sinks 3 points. And some of these uniforms, actually all of them, for UC Riverside do not have numbers on the front, so it's hard to see just who is who. Not much time to learn names and put faces to them. Jason Maturi was open for a moment. Instead, Jamie Chacon shot three. You see Riverside be able to take the rebound. Here's George Lee moving up. Gets the alley open, it goes out. Matadors have a 10-point lead. There's a turnover, and George Lee again moving up, tightly covered. And Jason Maturi, illegal contact. Cal Poly and Occidental are tied at 33 apiece. 6:22 remaining in the first half of that game. George Lee might take his time, just take a shot for two. Bounce off the outer rim. And Jordan Coleman moves up. Heated. That two-pointer will not count. That drew a foul. 6 minutes remaining here in the first half of this game between CSUN and UC Riverside. Nahida Ogogo coming out of the game. Isaiah Taylor back in. Norisco signaling to Burla. Move closer to him. Burla is able to put up two. Burrell is able to get the pass, but he's tightly covered when he catches it. James Pock, number 11, moving around trying to get some space, and Lloyd gets two. Oh, turnover. Victor Balderos loses control, and Marisco puts up two in the alley-oop. It's a five-point game. Jordan Coleman puts up two. Bounce off the outer rim, and a foul is drawn as Cybrill is able to get the rebound. 3:59 remaining. Clock is ticking. James Pock might take a three-point shot. He does. Bounces out and nearly goes out of bounds. Brian Moroccan passes Jane Randolph, but he gets fouled. Risey takes a shot from underneath the net. Lloyd moving up, and it gets deflected right underneath the net. Excellent defense by Jaden Randolph. Quick turnover there. Poor ball handling by Sean Nelson. That one, it's still in the field of play. Isaiah Taylor might just let it up, alley-oop, and he does. It's 33-24 CSUN. Sometimes when the whistle blows for the other court, it's hard to tell if it was on that court or not. Because sometimes you expect to see everyone stopping, but you don't. You know it was for the other game. One disadvantage here, having two games going on right next to each other. Lloyd puts it up for three. Looked like he was going to bounce in. Kyle English getting the rebound. Had a tape on his, I believe, two of his fingers, or one, on his left hand. Norisco tightly covered. Ball knocks out of his hands. Able to recover. Gets it to 23. That's Brian Beat. Mentors get the rebound. Oh, and a turnover. Cy Berla gets the poor pass. And it's deflected by Mikhail English, but Lloyd able to get the rebound and get the 2 points. Time's ticking down less than a minute now. 33-26 CSUN. Aiden Norisco will just take the three-point shot. Sinks it in, nothing but net. So four of their UC Riverside players have the last names on the back of their jerseys. Only number 23, Brian, and 10, Lloyd, do not. Turnover here, a slipping and falling. After forcing it, Mikhail English, and whistle is blown, no team scored. Here's go again, Isaiah Taylor moving up. He's put it up for two, they're passing it. And with his height, Jane Randolph puts up for two more, the first time we've seen that today. That's the end of the first half. CSUN leads 35-29. We'll be back for second half action in a few minutes. All right, welcome back. CSUN leads by six. They fix the score. Isaiah Taylor puts up the first points of the second half. It's 37-29. Nate Narisco trying to move around the defense, not able to. 23. We'll shoot for three and hit nowhere near the rim. Jordan Coleman puts up for two on the nice, quick, aggressive pass from Isaiah. And Matadors held a 10-point lead. The second half of the Cal Poly Occidental game about to begin. They're tied at 43 apiece. So, very tight, aggressive game there on the other court. Jay Taylor looking for a teammate, passes to, oh, and it gets the height of Jaden Randolph, gets it to him, but knocked out by UC Riverside. We'll do the same thing again. Randolph will just take the three-point shot. The Matadors look like they had were not going to get the rebound. They do get another shot. Doesn't go in that time either. James Pock. Right over to Lloyd. Nate Narisco back to Lloyd. He'll get two. As I mentioned before, UC Riverside was game planning to cover Mikhail English even before their match had started. They're watching from the other court. Joel Coleman looked like he was going to get the deflection, but UC Riverside had played it well and read his move and waited for him to jump and then shot it. Momentum carried him. He couldn't land right in front of the shooter. James Pock covered by Maturi. Narisco, pass it to George Lee. George Lee, looked past behind him, but his Cy Burla was not there. Miscommunication. Maturi tried to get the alley-oop, did not get it, and this time Burla on a second opportunity does. 43-35, CSUN. Very quick play here. Three shot attempts in the last 15 seconds. Two by CSUN, one by UC Riverside. And George Lee will sink a three-pointer. CSUN has been holding a steady lead for most of this game. Closest UC Riverside has gotten within to is five since towards the end of the first half. Game three of Knicks versus Heat starts at 12:30. They'll be at the Miami-Dade Arena down in South Florida. Let us know in the live chat or in the comments who you're pick to win that series is and advance to the Eastern Conference Finals. Lloyd puts up an easy two-pointer. Moving up, that's going to be an obvious travel. Trying to dribble there, but losing his balance. Mikhail English stumbling backwards. Looked like it was a travel. Maybe that was actually drawn a foul on Cy Burla, but he took more than two steps without dribbling the ball. Zay Taylor will pass it in. Oh, and off the back of Nate Norisco, goes right back to him, and he just takes it himself. That was not intentional. You see, he's very happy about that. I don't know if you can see his smile on the stream, but it's like that didn't go as planned, but I got 2 points out of it. James Pock tightly covered in their own territory by Isaiah Taylor. CSUN's approach to this matchup completely different, almost polar opposite to the one they had against Occidental. That one, they were taking their time and taking a lot of risks early on. That's why they found themselves down, and eventually they started nailing most of their three-pointers, but they were too far behind to catch up. Now they're trying to do the exact opposite. Put pressure early on, make UC Riverside second guess themselves. Further even across their half into their half of the court. Matadors only find themselves up by three. Got to re-extend that lead that they've kept all game. Mikhail English puts up two. Puts that up behind him. Was not looking at the basket when he shot it. Cy Burla covered closely, but here's Lloyd looking to shoot, and that'll be a... will roll out. Another shot. Matador's not going to look good for the rebound, even though they outnumber UC Riverside right now. Lloyd will get two. Jordan Coleman moving up. Shoulder to the upper body, and that'll draw a penalty. CSUN leads by five with less than 10 minutes remaining in this game. Kyle English trying to tell the UC Riverside players, change where you're standing, try to get in their heads. And drew a foul there, so it probably worked. That one called out on Sheldon Nelson. He looked like he's saying, UC Riverside touched it last. Does not agree with that call. Happened too quick. Wasn't at the right angle for us to see up here. Nariska will take the three-point shot. Arch is a little too short. Sean Nelson, get a chance to get two here. Puts it up. Kyle English get the rebound. Valderos moving up, trying to get two. Alley-oop, and it does. Bouncing off the rim a couple times and in. Right now, good game plan if you're CSUN. The approach to this is if you're up by seven, try to each possession get the ball. Try to run it down the shot clock as much as possible and tire UC Riverside out. You're up by five. You want to keep it that way. And also taking your time running down the shot clock gives them a chance to find the right angle, find the right spot to shoot from. Clock stop with 7:05 remaining. After the timeout now, play will resume. Jamie Chacon will pass it in to Victor Balderas. Balderas tightly covered. Clay Taylor will just take the three-point shot. Got the rebound and grabbing. Wasn't letting him move. Lloyd got his guys at Hiller's rebound. Risco moves up, tries to get the alley-oop. Does not get bounced in. CSUN regains possession. Maturi moving up into the paint. Takes a shot and deflected as it leaves his hand by Cy Berla. Lloyd passing to Norisco. Norisco moves up in the paint, pass it back to Lloyd, and they will get two. Zay Taylor might take it for himself. Nope. Jaden Randolph passes it to Maturi. Trying to find an opening. UC Riverside playing tighter defense now that the lead is within range. Oh, and it nearly goes out of bounds off the leg of Norisco. Staying in bounds. It nearly had a chance to go out of bounds a couple times now. That's about three on this possession alone. And now UC Riverside takes over. CSUN struggling to score here. They could tie it up with a three-pointer right here. They won't. George Lee pass it to Berla. He's going to take it to three, and he does, and it's a tie game, 55 apiece, with 5 minutes remaining. And suddenly that lead is evaporated, the first time it's been tied since it was the game was 0-0. Ryan puts it up. Norisco getting the rebound. Shot was just a little too far over the net. Did not hit the backboard in time to bounce into the net. With that free throw by Norisco, UC Riverside has their first lead of this game. Clock is ticking down, less than 4 minutes to go. Game could go down to the final seconds, depending on who has the ball last. Timeout called. 3:34 remaining in this game. And over on the other court, Occidental leads Cal Poly 72-69 with 4 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in that game. So in this game here, one team will win their first game. The other side, one team will lose their first game. Battle of the undefeateds versus the defeateds. James Pock taking his time now that they have a lead. They have a little bit more leeway to try and engage CSUN's defense. Pock looking to keep it to himself. Berla might move up, might stay outside the three-point line. Pock moving back, might get fouled here for stepping back over that line while still in possession of the ball. Nearly does. He passed it just at the last second. George Lee taking it, passes it to Lloyd, puts it up for two, bounces out, and CSUN will get the rebound. Have a chance to tie it up the game here. But they're nearly trying to get it in, trying to tip it in. They don't. George Lee pass it to Brian. Gets it to James Pock, moving down the court. 2:18 remaining. Pock gets it to George Lee, who nearly loses possession of it. Triple teamed right there. And a foul by Mikhail English. Nearly committed a turnover there. Jordan Coleman was ready to scoop that. Would have had no one in front of him. Risco lost possession of it there as he was dribbling in between his legs. Trying to play fancy, but it could result in a turnover. It bounces off your leg. And Sean Nelson is the first to pick up speed and go and get the ball. Two-pointer didn't count because the foul was committed. A high collision there. There'll be two free throws coming up here from Mikhail English. They're standing still in the paint, trying to throw him off balance. It's 42 seconds remaining in this game. Both teams have struggled to score here in the last 7 minutes. A lot of missed shots. The lead has changed. Different story than the rest of the game. They get a three-pointer here. This game is just about done. Matadors will be down by four. It's only time for one possession remaining. Riverside taking their time. The time is ticking. If they don't get a shot, and whistle's called. Sixteen seconds remaining. Time out quickly while they deliberate on the sideline. The officials are talking about something. The desk in the middle. Ball is not in sight yet. Mariners have a chance to tie it right here, and they do. And no, a foul was committed, and that two will not count. And there's 8.2 seconds remaining, and UC Riverside erupting in applause. They will get the ball. And all they have to do is dribble and run the clock out. And CSUN look like they're about to go down 0-2 and be the only team without a win here after two rounds. Let's go put some free throw, the 3-point game. One more game will seal the victory for UC Riverside. That's the game. 7 seconds remain. Matador's trail by 4. And that's the end of the game. It's 62-61 is the final score. So Matadors fall to 0-2, the only team without a win through two rounds here. We'll see you soon for round 3. Thank you for watching.